Hi and welcome to ISBI. Today I'm gonna make a fixed installed digital angle gauge for the table saw. Recently I saw this on a German YouTube channel called Fronix Bastelbude. I found it so cool that I had to think about it what Bobby Duke Arts would say now. Right, I want that. It is quite simple to build. If you can solder and use a computer, you can build that too. Here are all electronic components you need for this project. An Arduino Nano or an Allego Nano. A 7-segment display with 4 digits. A gyroscope sensor. 2 lockless push-button switches. A connector for a 9-volt battery. A power switch. A 9-volt battery. And some additional things like wires, a perf board, etc. Because of the fact that I had some on-off push-button switches laying around and I don't wanted to buy others, I decide to convert them to lockless switches. All I had to do was to carefully open the switch and remove one tiny component. I removed the spring and took everything out. You have to pay attention to the arrangement of the components, that you are able to get this back together. By the way, a link to all components are in the description, just in case you want to build that too. One of the components is a small brass piece with a tiny wire hook attached to. This tiny hook is the part that I remove. And that's it. Reassembled, it is a lockless push button now. First, I solder the pin header connectors to the Allego Nano. Before I solder everything to a perf board, I test it on a breadboard. As everything was working, I solder everything to a perf board. For the soldering sequence, I let the video run faster. After this sequence, I show you how the components must be connected. and this is how it looks after soldering. I just have to plug in the Allego Nano in the socket. Now I show you how the components must be connected. Here are all components again. The 9-volt battery, the power switch, the Allego Nano, the gyroscope sensor, the 7-segment display viewed from the back, and 2 push-button switches. One of the switches, in this case the left one, will be used to calibrate the zero position and the other to calibrate the 45-degree position. And now the actual wiring. Ground from the battery goes to ground of the Allego Nano, the 7-segment display and the gyroscope sensor, and to one of the pins of the 2 switches. Plus 9 volt from the battery goes to the power switch and from the switch to volt in of the Allego Nano. 5 volt from the Allego Nano will be used to power the gyroscope sensor and the 7-segment display. From the other pin of the zero position switch goes a wire to D4 of the Allego Nano, and from the 45-degree switch goes a wire to D5. From SCL of the gyroscope sensor goes a wire to A5 and from SDA to A4. From DIO of the display goes a wire to D3 and from CLK to D2. And that's the whole wiring. Now that the wiring is done, the code must be uploaded to the Allego Nano. To upload the code to the Allego Nano, you will need a program called Arduino IDE. You can download this program from the Arduino homepage. Go to Software, Downloads, and choose the link that fits your system. Here you can donate if you want to, or just click on Just Download. And then you just have to install the program. If you are using an Allego Nano, you have to download the USB driver from the Allego homepage. If you are using an original Arduino Nano, you can skip this step. After installing the USB driver, you have to restart the computer. To download the code, you have to click on the link in the description. A window of My Google Drive will pop up. There is a folder called ISBI Angle Gauge. Download that folder. In this folder is a file called anglegauge.ino. That's the file you have to open with the Arduino IDE. Now you have to connect the Nano with an USB cable to the computer. Now you have to make some settings in the program. Go to Tools, Board, and choose Arduino Nano, even if you're using an Allego Nano. Go to Port and choose the USB port that pops up. On processor, choose Atmega 328P. If that's not working, choose the old bootloader instead. In my case, I had to choose the old bootloader. With the Nano still connected to the computer, click on the arrow on the top of the program, and the code will be uploaded to the Nano. After the code is uploaded, you can disconnect the Nano. Time to connect everything together and see if it works. I don't solder the switches and the gyroscope sensor. Because I have to mount the switches from the outside of the case and I wanted the gyroscope sensor to be removable, just in case. I switched it on, et voila, it works as it should. As you can see, I have used a display with a colon that would be normally used for a clock. Nicer would be a display with decimal points, but hey, I have it laying around and it works as well. Now it's time to make a quick and dirty case for the electronics. I made no plan for the case, so I tried to figure out the size of the case by laying the components on a piece of 6mm plywood. Then I cut all the parts for the case to the proper size. I decide to make a separate compartment for the battery. I take some measurements and after that I cut the pieces for the battery compartment out of 3mm MDF. I pre-glue some of the battery compartment pieces. I use a small spacer to be sure that the battery has enough play and don't sit too firm. Then I use this battery compartment piece to make some marks that I use to determine the size of the recess in the back wall. To make the recess, I change the blade to a flat tooth blade. I assemble the first parts of the case by using glue and nails. Here I glue on the last piece of the battery compartment. For the push-button switches, I drill holes in the side pieces of the case. To make the recess for the power switch, I drill two holes and use files for final shaping. Then I repeat the same procedure for the recess for the display. I made an additional recess in the side piece in which the power switch will be mounted in to feed the cable for the gyroscope sensor through. And I have cut some additional pieces that I glue to the side pieces. These pieces allow me to mount the push button switches recessed later. Here I glue in two more pieces so the battery cover has a surface to be screwed on. I use a Forstner bit to mark the center of the holes for the push buttons and drill them. To have more material to screw on the top cover, I glue in some additional pieces. Next, I glue and nail the side pieces in place. And then I glue in the battery compartment as well. Here I drill the screw holes for the top cover and the battery compartment cover. And then it's time to install all the electronics. The last thing I have to do is to install the device to the table saw. Through this gap, I will feed the cable of the sensor. First, I wanted to mount the sensor on top of the pivot unit of the table saw, but then I decided to mount the sensor lower. There, on the outside of this cover, will the sensor be attached to. Fortunately, I have built this dust drawer underneath the table saw, so I can reach in the inside of the saw if the drawer is pulled out. I hope you can see it. Here I clean the area where the sensor will be attached with hot glue. Here I feed the sensor cable through. I wrap the sensor in electrical tape to prevent it from becoming dusty. Here I glue in the sensor and test if everything works properly. Then I set in a saw blade to make the final calibration. To calibrate the sensor, I set the saw blade exactly vertical and push the button to set the zero position. In my case, the white button. Then I set the saw blade to 45 degree and push the other button to set the 45 degree position. In my case, the red button. These settings will be saved to the EEPROM. This means these settings will not be lost if the device is turned off. I repeated these steps once again and tested if the angles are set precise enough. I'm very happy with this device. From now on, I just have to turn it on and set my needed angle. That is very useful, in my opinion. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click the notification bell and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!